up? Welcome back to All Around. I hope you are doing well. So today's video is about HTML and we are learning computing. And so guys, well, to get started, if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out any of our new videos. So what is HTML? HTML is hypertext markup language, the full form of HTML. HTML is a markup language which is used by the browser to manipulate text, images and other content to display it in the required format. HTML was created by Tim Berners-Lee in 1991. First ever version of HTML was HTML 1.0 or 1.0, but the standard version of HTML was 2.0, which was published in 1999 and still going on. It allows the users to create and structure sections, paragraphs, headings, links, and block codes for web pages and applications. So HTML is a language, for example, a programming language, and it is typed in Notepad. We are going to learn that also, how to type HTML, and you'll get to know it. So what is a web browser? A web browser is a software program that allows a user to locate, access, and display web pages. So there are many web browsers such as Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Microsoft Internet Explorer, Opera, Apple Safari. Google Chrome and Apple Safari are commonly used in and for devices such as tablets and phones. But in laptops, you find everything such as Mozilla Firefox, Microsoft Internet Explorer, Google Chrome. So browsers are used primarily for displaying and accessing websites on the internet as well as other content created using languages such as HTML. So to access the website and to and the content created by HTML, we can use a web browser to view it. So there are HTML tags. HTML uses tags and elements to create the basic structure of the web page. Elements are used to control how the text appears on a web page. And a tag is a command that defines the beginning and the end of an element. For example, HTML is opening tag and /HTML is a closing tag. So guys, let me tell you one thing, that all the HTML tags usually come in angular brackets, as you can see down. For example, in the math we use the greater and lesser sign, just like that. And that is the opening tag, and the closing tag you put slash. You can see /HTML in the last line. We're gonna learn about more about tags. So this is the basic structure of a web page. We start with HTML in angular brackets. Then write head is the just to what it show in the, you know, the bar, the title bar where we search, and title is the thing with what will come, title of the web page, /title. And guys, the head or title don't accept to be heading is different than heading. If you want to put a heading, we're gonna know about that also, but don't accept your head to be your title and all. Just for the computer here, it won't be readable on the web page. And the body is them, like the main content, your pictures, images, text. You also write /body is closing, body is opening. And the HTML marks the end of the web page. So after you've done all things, you write HTML. The body tag contains the content of the web page, as I told you. Head tag contains information about the web page. Title contains the web page title. And the HTML tags indicate that this page is written in HTML. Now to create HTML, for steps to create a simple web page with a text editor. So first of all, you have to open Notepad in PC or laptop. But if you want to do it in a tablet or phone, I'm gonna put the link in the description. You can find it there and download it from Play Store. Or if you have Windows 8 or later, open the start screen, the Windows symbol at the bottom left of your screen. Type Notepad. If Windows 7 or earlier, open Start, Programs, Accessories, Notepad. For Mac, Text Edit, you have to open Finder, Applications, and Text Edit. Also, change some preferences to get the application to save files correctly. In Preferences, choose Format, choose Plain Text. Then under Open and Save, check the box that says Display HTML files as HTML code instead of formatted text. Then open a new document to place the code. Okay, then you write some HTML. So first of all, begin HTML body. We don't write actually the heading, because if we don't want to, so we can just skip it. body. H1 is a heading, in p tag is a paragraph tag. We're gonna learn more about it. And then you have to save the HTML. Save the file on your computer. Select file, save as in notepad menu. Select the name the file index.html. You can name it anything like s.html, but should be .html. Then step 4, view the HTML within your browser. Open the saved HTML file in your favorite browser. Double click on the file or right click and choose open with. Okay, next. HTML documents. So this is also a tag. All HTML documents must start with the document type declaration, that is angular bracket, exclamation mark, doc type HTML, angular brackets, close. And this tag does not need to close, like there's no slash for this. The tag does not need to be closed. Tells the browser what language is reading by defining the document type. So at the top of your page, this is starting, you have to write doc type HTML, HTML head, as you can see in the black box, and then you continue. And heading tags. Headings are defined. Yeah, this is the part if you want a heading for your web page. Headings are defined with the H1 to H6 tags. H1 defines the most important tag, that means the biggest. It will have a big font and it will be bold, while H6 will be very small and it will not be bold. We're gonna see that how it works. So first of all, write H1 heading 1, H2 heading 2, H3 heading 3. Guys, remember that if you write H1, the closing will also be H1, H2 closing H2. And then you can see the result is like the heading 1 is bigger, is quite big than the heading 6. So heading 1 is like the main heading, and heading 6 like a subtitle, subheading I mean, sorry. Now paragraph tags. HTML paragraphs are defined with the p tag. It is placed inside a body tag and below the heading tag. So in the body tag you can place p, write a text, close, then angular bracket slash p. We're gonna see how it works. So we, in this, we wrote a paragraph, my first heading, we write a H1, and then P, my first paragraph. This is an example of using paragraph in HTML. And you can see the results, and then again, you can use as many times as you want the P tag. But once you open it, you should close it. Then again, if you want to another one, you can open it. Okay. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you liked it, and I'm gonna put another video for HTML. You should watch it if you want to learn more about HTML. Thank you so much. Don't forget to like and subscribe our channel and comment about next video. Thank you.